In our culture today, discipline can be a difficult thing to swallow. The world tells us that discipline is either for bad people, like kids who misbehave and got detention, or it's something physical, like sports training. Because discipline is often painful, many people don't want to make it part of their lives. Even a spiritual discipline requires that we give something up to make time for a new habit. Giving up is a sacrifice, and sacrifice can be painful. Let's read Hebrews 12, verse 11. No discipline seems pleasant at the time, but painful. Later on, however, it produces a harvest of righteousness and peace for those who have been trained by it. It can be hard to work on something now when we don't see immediate benefits. Many do not understand why we should discipline ourselves or help others to do the same. As we pursue Christ-like living, we need to look at what the Word of God says about why we should be spiritually disciplined. Let's read what Paul wrote in 1 Corinthians 9, verses 24 to 27. Do you not know that in a race all the runners run, but only one gets the prize? Run in such a way as to get the prize. Everyone who competes in the games goes into strict training. They do it to get a crown that will not last, but we do it to get a crown that will last forever. Therefore, I do not run like someone running aimlessly. I do not fight like a boxer beating the air. No, I strike a blow to my body and make it my slave, so that after I have preached to others, I myself will not be disqualified for the prize. Paul used the well-known Greek games to make his point. His readers will have known what people had to go through to participate in the games. They were required to take part in 10 months of strict training as mandatory discipline in order to compete. The Greek word for compete is what we get the word agony. It was hard work to prepare. Not only it was a hard work, but a prize wasn't guaranteed. Only one person will win first place. They would have gotten a wreath made out of leaves that would rot. There were no participation medals, only one winner. In contrast, Paul says that the spiritual discipline we go through is for an eternal prize, and everyone will be awarded if they stay in the game. We do not earn our salvation. Jesus did that for us on the cross. That's not what our training is for. We train spiritually so that we can stay on the path of faith, living in a close relationship with God now, and enjoy the eternal reward of being in His presence forever. So what are these disciplines we're talking about? Some are outward, some are corporate, and some are inward. Let's look at each one briefly. Outward disciplines directly affect others. They include simplicity, solitude, submission, and service. This may not seem obviously outward other than service, but we will learn more about them in our next lesson. Corporate disciplines are done in community. They include confession, worship, guidance, and celebration. Finally, inward disciplines are done more privately. They include meditation, prayer, fasting, and study. Some lists include other disciplines, but these are the basic ones we will cover. They can be divided into two categories, personal and interpersonal. They are either done on our own or done with others or for others. There are two basic spiritual disciplines out of which all others flow, Bible study and prayer. These are both inward or personal disciplines. We need fellowship and community to live out our life of faith. That's incredibly important. But when it comes down to it, to grow our spiritual muscles, we need to talk to God regularly and listen to Him on our personal level.